China's new supercarrier Type-003, how it compares to the US Navy's Ford-class carrier. Aircraft carriers are a strategic priority for the world's leading navies. Experienced players such as the Royal Navy, French Navy and Indian Navy are all in the process of bringing in new carriers. And Japan, South Korea and likely other countries are all taking steps to join the club. But nowhere is the capability gathering steam as much as in China. The Chinese Navy, PLAN, has already commissioned two carriers based on the Russian Admiral Kutzenov class. But their third and upcoming carrier, known as Type-003, Future Carriers, promises to take the plan to the next level. A new aircraft carrier, currently under construction in Shanghai, is the most visible sign of China's rapidly expanding navy. It is larger than China's current two carriers and differs in key aspects. But the natural comparison is to the US Navy's latest carriers, the Ford class. Meanwhile, the US Navy, for decades the world leader in this technology, is also modernizing with a new class of supercarrier. The first Ford-class ship, USS Gerald R. Ford, CVN-78, was commissioned in 2017. The Type-003 is very close in size to the US Navy's carriers. And although the definition is vague, it seems fair to also describe it as a supercarrier. Fresh commercial satellite imagery from CompSat, via Shadowbreak INTI, allows us to finally measure the size and layout of the Type-003. This permits a general high-level comparison to the Ford class. The imagery shows that it is approximately 320 meters long. This is about 13 meters shorter than the Ford class. The Chinese ship does have a narrower flight deck, however, its width of about 73 meters is very similar to preceding Type-001 and Type-002 carriers. There may be logistical reasons for this, such as dry dock sizes. Or it may simply be that the Chinese planners were happy with the width of the current carriers. Going electromagnetic. The major step change over the current carriers, however, is in how aircraft will be launched. The new ship is Catabar, catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery, while the first two are Stobar, short takeoff but arrested recovery. Like the Ford class, the Type-003 and future carriers are believed to use an electromagnetic aircraft launch system, EMALS, instead of a steam catapult. This should promise a faster launch rate. Catapults, Chinese carriers, will allow new aircraft types to be carried. A new fixed-wing airborne early warning and control aircraft, the KJ-600, is expected to be aboard. This is, both in role and overall form, very similar to the E-2D Advanced Hawkeye. Other new aircraft are expected to include a carrier version of the J-31 stealth fighter. This will be generally equivalent of the Ford class's F-35 Sea Lightning II. The Ford class has three aircraft elevators, lifts, should provide a greater sortie rate than the Type-003. The Chinese ship, however, has only two. However, on paper the Chinese carrier should have a larger usable deck area thanks to fewer lifts. This may not be seen as a wise trade-off as it will take the Chinese longer to move aircraft up from the hangar. The Type-003 appears to have inherited its twin lift arrangement directly from the Russian Admiral Kutzenov class. To summarize, the Type-003 is slightly smaller in overall dimensions. It has fewer catapults and fewer aircraft elevators, which may reduce sortie rates. In general, the American ship is a bold evolutionary leap based on decades of operational experience. The Chinese lacks the vast experience of the US Navy, but it is all the same rapidly gaining experience. It has been operating carriers for nearly 10 years and is clearly heavily invested in making them a success. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.